good deep breath and let's do some cleansing techniques. Let's get rid of some carbon dioxide and cleanse our lungs a little bit by forcing some air out through our nostrils. And now let's do that a little deeper by just pushing out through our mouth. Deep breath. If it brings up a cough, that's good. And now let's do some a little bit deeper cleansing by just blowing out through our mouth, like we're blowing out candles. For as long as you can. To cleanse a little bit, get that respiratory tract cleansed. Deep breath. And now let's slow down a little bit by doing some alternate nostril breathing. With your right hand, put your thumb on your right nostril, your ring finger on your left nostril, the other two fingers up between your eyes, and push with that ring finger against your left nostril to close it, open up the right nostril and inhale through. For as long as you want to. And then hold that breath in your lungs. Just pinch your nose closed, hold it there for as long as it feels good, and then exhale through that left nostril. Now try to exhale as long as you can. When you know you can't exhale any longer, you're ready to inhale. Inhale back through that open nostril. Feel that. Close your nose, hold it there. And when you're ready to exhale, exhale through the right nostril only. For as long as you can. Let's do that again. This time, see if you can count to see how long you inhale. Stop your count now and hold your breath in your lungs for that same count. Start counting again. And when you reach the same length of time you inhale, exhale through that left nostril twice as long if you can. Just keep counting. Exhale. When you're ready to inhale, inhale back through that left nostril. Counting, seeing how long you inhaled. Close your nose, hold that breath in your lungs for that same length of time. And then exhale through that right nostril. Twice as long if you can. You can do that again on your own. When you finish that, and you'll notice that if you're doing this yoga with anyone else in the room with you, everybody finishes at a different time because you all have different lung capacities. Okay, good deep breath now and feel how well you can breathe. See if that feels better too. And then let's let's see about doing a line. Put your hands on your thighs, push down, you can push against your knees or your thighs, get a good deep breath, and roar loud. Feel that all the way down into your lungs. Feel it all the way up into your face, into your head. That's the lion. We can also do that same thing again and call it the silent scream, and that's to cleanse your mind, get your thinking straight. But this time, see if you can't stick your tongue out a little further, bug your eyes a little bigger, and scream a little louder. Silent scream. Good job. Thank you. Good deep breath. Feel that. notice how you feel after you've done anything when you practice yoga and see what how it affected you. And give yourself some time to get over it. Now then, let's do some alternate. Have you already done alternate nostril breathing? Okay. Let's do some easing techniques. Drop your head, relax your back, and just sit up straight with your shoulders up, back, and down. But now, feel that relaxation in the back of your neck. Notice how you feel at the front of your throat. Feel that relaxation. Now, slowly roll your head to your right shoulder. Feel that stretch on the left side of your neck. Feel the right side of your neck relaxing. And then as you roll across your back, just go ahead and take a good deep breath all the way across the back. And go around to that left shoulder. Relax. Feel that. Feel the stretch on the right side of your neck now. And then if you're rolling across your chest now, you're exhaling as you go. And you can match this breathing to how fast you want to roll around, or you can just roll around and match your breathing to how fast you roll around. Either way, it works. Inhaling as you roll across your back, and then exhaling as you roll across your chin, across your chest. When you've done a few of those, stop and feel that. Breathe into it. Notice how it feels to have stretched your neck on one side and relaxed it on the other, and been aware of your breathing at the same time. That's what we're doing now. We're going to go back in the opposite direction. As you roll back toward that left shoulder, feel that stretch on the right side of your neck, the relaxation on the left, then roll your head across your back. And you can stop back there. Just let your head hang back toward your spine. But if you stop, you want to be breathing. You don't hold your breath if you stop. Roll around to your right shoulder. Relax that side of the neck over there on the right, and feel that stretch on the left. And you're breathing. And then roll across your chest. And match your breathing to your roll. If you roll around fast enough, you can breathe when you roll across your back. And then you can exhale as you roll across the front. But if you stop anywhere along the line, you want to get some good breaths while you're there. When you finish, get a good deep breath and notice how both sides of your neck feel now. Breathe into what you feel. And then let's release that and do some shoulder rolls. Pull your shoulders forward and up as you inhale. Pull them back and down as you exhale. Feel that. Inhale and pull them forward up. Inhale up toward your ears, and as you roll far back as you can and down, exhale. You might want to even pick your arms up so you can really feel that. Pull your elbows back behind you as you roll. When you've done a few of those, enough that you can feel it in your shoulders and into your neck, then just stop, get you a deep breath, and let's reverse that now. Pull back with your elbows coming back behind you as you inhale and up toward your ears, and then exhale as you go forward and down in front of you. Make that extreme, really feel it. Inhale coming back and up, exhale going forward and down. And you're rolling those shoulders carefully, not hurting anything, but just giving some good pressure to it. Exhale as you go down. Drop back. Relax. Get a good deep breath. Feel the effects from doing those shoulder rolls. And then let's just stretch our legs out. When you feel the backs of your legs against the floor, take a deep breath and feel what it's like to have your legs just stretched in front of you. You can even pull your toes back toward you a little bit. Feel that. And now we're just going to do the forward bend. Inhale as you raise your arms up. Exhale as you lean back and feel that pull. Inhale as you stretch up. Try to reach the ceiling. And then exhale as you reach out in front of you, like you're going to try to reach that wall in front of you. And then just relax down and try to reach your feet. Don't mind if you can't reach your feet. Just relax. Let your head fall. Let your shoulders relax. Feel that stretch in your back. Feel that stretch in your legs. But nothing hurts. Don't let anything hurt. You want to always be breathing, and you never want to be hurting when you're doing yoga. Yoga meets you where you are, and you don't have to do anything that doesn't feel good to your body. Let your head fall. Relax your neck again. Even though you think your neck is relaxed, if you tell it to relax again, it will. When you get ready to come out of that, and you stay as long as you like, even if I talk about coming out, go ahead and stay there if it feels good to you. Or if you want to come out early, do that. But when you come out, see if you can just inhale as you slowly roll the back of the end of your spine up. Roll up your back one vertebra at a time, bringing up your shoulders, and then pulling your shoulders back and down, and exhale as you feel that. Breathe and feel where you're feeling it. You may be feeling that blood flow going down your legs into your feet now. You may be feeling it coming up your spine, into your neck and head. Just see where you can feel that you got a benefit from doing that forward bend. And give your body time to enjoy it. Breathe into it, relax, and then get a good deep breath. Just inhale and exhale. And let's do the knee thigh stretch. Feed up to you. Book, the bottoms of your feet are together like pages in a book. Hold to your feet and just kind of pull your feet back as close to you as it feels good to you. Be careful with your knees. Watch your knees. Notice how it feels and don't do anything that hurts. But try to get your spine straight. Try to make your back knee straight. Pull your shoulders back and down. Suck in your belly. Tighten your sphincter muscles. Pull your feet up a little closer to you. And pull your knees down a little closer to the floor. And cast your eyes down. Have your eyes either closed or just staring at the floor. Breathe and feel this position. Now check on your position. While you're breathing, thinking about breathing, also check to see if you got your shoulders back and down. See if you pulled your knees down as far as they'll come. See if your sphincter muscles are still tightened. Suck in your belly like you're trying to pull your navel back toward your spine. And just breathe. Just breathe and hold this position the best that you can. And keep reminding yourself of what you're doing. You're feeling your body. You're breathing. And you're noticing how long you're here. Some of us like to count. Some people like to count the breaths. Just notice how you know how long you've been here. And then come out when you're ready. Relax out. Relax your knees, let them come up. Relax your fingers and hands, roll your ankles around. Roll your wrist around. These are wrists, these are ankles. Good deep breath. Just relax. And let's just lean back for a minute. Just lean back on your hands. Push your chest out and drop your head back. And do that backward bend. Some of us like to do the backward bend up on our knees, with the tops of feet on the floor, and lean back just like you're doing now. And we lean back on our hands and drop our head way back. But if you're comfortable the way you were, just stay seated and lean back. But if you'd like to get on your knees and put your hips down on your heels and lean back, do this backward bend with me. When you get ready to come out of this backward bend, you relax the arch in your chest, raise your head, inhale coming up. And when, if you're in the one where you just lean back, just turn around and let's all get into the pose of the child. Just slowly move your body around until you're on your knees and you've got your toes turned under behind you and you've got your head down on your hands. Just relax. Feel that. This is a position you can get into anytime to relax from what you just did. But it's also a good position just in itself to help your body. Okay, let's get in what we call a tabletop. Just if you raise up and get your knees under your hips and get your wrist under your shoulders, you'll be in the tabletop. Put the tops of your feet down on the floor and feel that. Just notice that your arms are straight right under your shoulders and your knees are right under your hips, so your legs are straight. It's just like table legs. Get a good deep breath and look up and let your back sag. And then arch your back as you exhale. Push your back way up, pull your chin in tight, and exhale. Inhale again as we do that. Look up, inhale it, let your back sag, relax. Arch your back again, suck up your belly, tuck in your chin. This time when we look up and inhale, raise one leg up. Pull that leg up behind you. Now we're gonna be here for a breath or two, just breathe. And if you like this, you can do two or three breaths or more. If you're ready to come out, exhale when you bring that knee in toward your forehead. And then set your knee down and look up again, inhaling, letting your back sag. Arch your back again, suck up your belly, tuck in your chin, and let's do that other leg this time. Inhale, raise that leg up as high as you can, and then pull that knee into your forehead. Feel that. When you set that knee back down, get your good deep breath. And we're gonna do that again, and then add a little something to it this time. Look up, inhaling, letting your back sag. Arch your back, suck up your belly, tuck in your chin. This time, when you look up and raise that one leg, see if you can bring the opposite hand up, and then be there on one leg and one hand, and have the other opposite hand and leg in the air. But breathe, don't hold your breath. When you're ready to come out of that, exhale, get that hand back down, feel that position, relax, let your belly hang, look up at the ceiling, inhaling, arch your back, suck up your belly, tuck in your chin, inhale as we look up again, and raise that other leg. Feel that. Breathing. Notice which hand and leg you got up this time. It's the opposite one. It may feel different to you. It should. When you're ready to come out of that, set that hand back down. Relax. And let's go back into the pose of the child again. And there's another pose of the child. Keep your toes together. Spread your knees apart. And leave your hands way up in front of you. And try to stretch up as far as you can with your knees as far apart as it feels good. Your hips are going back there near your heels. You're reaching your hands, trying to reach the end of your mat. And we just call this the melting heart. Just let your heart hang down toward the floor. Feel that. It's a good hip opener. Just breathe. When you're ready to come out of that, let's just ease our way up to the end of the mat. Coming forward, just walk your hands up and get on your belly. When you get feeling like you're comfortable with your hips down, your legs straight behind you, your elbows on the floor, let's just put our chin in our hands and breathe. Just relax like you were going to be here for a while. Feel your feet and legs, let them relax. Notice where you feel this position now. It may not be in your neck, it may be in lower on in your spine. But we're going to do the neck stretch by inhaling as we turn our head to the right and hook your chin in that right hand, the left side of your chin in your right hand. Let the back of your head fall into that other hand. And that's the neck stretch. Just feel that. Breathe. Think about how your body feels in this position. And when you're ready to come out of it, inhale as you come back around, and exhale as you put your chin back in both hands. Relax and breathe. Let's turn in the other direction. Inhale, turn to the left, hook the right side of your chin in that left hand, pull that left hand back toward that left shoulder, and let the back of your head fall into your right hand. Feel that. And breathe. When you come back from that, inhale as you come around, exhale, let your elbows be right under your shoulders, leave your hands right in front of you, and we'll just be in the Sphinx position. Just feel that, and breathe. Notice how your neck feels after doing the neck stretch. Notice how you feel in the Sphinx position. See if you like this, and just be comfortable here. And then let's just roll over on your back. If you can get completely comfortable on your back for just a moment, see how that feels, the way we've just done some things that worked with our spine. See if your spine is willing to just be in the floor there for a minute. And if not, go ahead and bend your knees and let the bottoms of your feet be on the floor. Sometimes your back likes that better. And if you want to do that, just have your feet down flat. And you can push your hands against the floor and pick your hips up and get into that position. Feel that. Some of us like to hold on to our ankles and pick our hips up. You can do that. Or you can just make a fist under your body and push your arms against the floor with that tight fist, pushing down to keep those hips up, and then just drop your hips back. Relax. And let your knees come to your chest and hug your knees. Feel that. Now, place your arms out to each side and leave your knees bent and just tip your knees to the right a little bit. And then just tip your knees back to the left a little bit and feel that. Just notice how that feels to do that. And then we're going to make some circles. Pull your knees up toward your chest and round to the left. And then your feet are going down toward the floor a little bit. And then bring your knees back to the right. And you feel that big circle you just made? Make another one. Just make a circle with your knees. Breathe while you're doing that. Do you notice where you want to breathe? You tend to want to exhale when you get your knees up close to your chest. And you tend to want to inhale when they push out away from you maybe. When you stop that, relax and reverse it. Pull around to the left first and up to the right and around and down. Feel that. Just roll around. Let your back feel what's going on as you roll your knees. Do that as much as you want to. When you get ready to stop, just put your feet back flat on the floor. Feel your body. Spread your knees apart and grab your toes. And let's get in the happy baby. This is called a happy baby. You just pick your feet up and spread your legs out and feel that. Bring your feet back together. And you can keep doing that for several minutes if you wanted to work with your knees and with your back. And some of us like to get in what we call the plow. We pick our feet up and bring our feet back behind us. And walk our hands up our back and bring our chins to our chest. But you may like to just stay in a happy baby. But if you like to do the plow, bring your feet back behind you. And once you get your feet back there and you walk your hands up your back, then you can bring your hands around and put them back on your feet again. And you'll be just like people who are doing the happy baby, except your feet are going to be back behind you instead of up over you. And when you get ready to roll out of that, you can just come out with your hands on your feet if you wanted to, but you want to be sure to let your head look back behind you. Look back at your feet as you're coming down. Or you can put your hands on the floor and hold yourself when you come down. When you get back in the happy baby, bring your feet back together in front of you, and then let's all lower our feet to the floor without bending our knees. See if you can do that. And if you can't, don't worry about it. Just bend your knees if they insist. And let your feet come to the floor. But you're using a lot of core muscles if you'll just lower your feet to the floor without bending your knees. Just feel that. And relax. Breathe. Feel what we just did. When you're ready to rise up, inhale the best you can when you're coming up. And when you sit up, spread your legs out to the side. And let's do the leg spread. Get your legs spread. We're gonna reach for our feet. Inhale and exhale as you let your hands just come down your legs toward your feet. However far down your legs they go, that's just fine, because once you feel it inside your thighs or once you're feeling it in your back, you're there far enough. Just drop your head, relax your neck, and feel your head fall toward the floor. That's what you want, is relaxing the back of your neck, relaxing your shoulders, and letting your arms just do whatever they want to do. Wherever they want to end up is fine. Relax and breathe. Feel that. When you get ready to come out of that, and come out at any time, wait for me to say come out, or if you're not ready, stay in there even when I'm coming out, but you want to be inhaling when you come up. Exhale, relax. When you come out, just feel the effects of what you just did. Breathe into what you feel, and then bring your feet together. Legs in front of you and your hands back behind you. Let's do the inclined plane. If you just let your weight be on your heels and your hands, and you just pick your hips up and look up at the ceiling with your back straight. Get the back of your head even with the back of your shoulders and your hips and your heels to get you in a complete inclined plane. Try not to let your hips be hanging down. Push your pelvis up toward the ceiling and breathe. Hold that as long as it feels good to your body. You know when you need to come out of it. Just sit down. Relax. Get a good deep breath. Feel your hands, feel your wrist, your ankles, and your feet. Relax everything that you used when you were in that position and let yourself be aware of what your body just did for you. Good deep breath. Okay, let's stand. Slowly notice every move that you make when you start getting up. Notice the muscles that you've used to get you up, and you get up slowly. Pay attention to how it feels. Deep breath. Okay. Let's do the wide leg spread first. Just spread your legs out away from you. And put your hands on your thighs. Excuse me. Deep breath. Don't let your back bend. Keep your back straight and just bend at the hips. Reach for your knees, bending only at the hips. Your back is straight. You're just reaching down toward your legs with a straight back, and once you realize that this is as far as you can bend from the hips, you don't want your back to bend, you want your back stiff, then you can reach your hands down toward the floor if you want to, and it might be that you can go on down toward the floor with a straight back, but notice that, feel it, and see if you can, or you can reach your hands all the way down your legs to your feet. Just let your body be the boss. And you feel it so that you're bending only at the hips. When you get ready to come out, you can just relax your arms and come out, or you can let your hands help you a little bit by coming up your legs as you raise back up. Inhaling as you come up, feel that. Relax your legs. Relax from that position. Let your body know what you did with it and what it did for you. Just feel that. Since we have our legs apart, let's just have them about to the edge of our mat, and let's do the revolve triangle. Inhale as you bring your arms up and revolve around until you've reached for the other side of the floor. Reach that hand down. You can just put it on your leg. Let that hand go down your leg. Bring that other arm up toward the ceiling as that hand comes down, but be sure that you haven't twisted your hips in. You want your spine still straight. You want the back of your spine right straight back behind you. And you're reaching for the floor, and you're reaching for the ceiling, but your hips are back behind you. Just hold that arm up as high as you look up toward it, see if you can see that hand up there. Pull that shoulder back a little bit. When you're ready to come out of that, bring that other arm up and get in the Superman pose and come out of that. Inhaling as you come up, exhale as your arms come down. Good deep breath. Now, if we didn't stay in that long enough, you'd stay in it longer. You don't have to come out when I do. If you like that position, stay longer. Let's do the other side. Inhale as you come up. Exhale as you revolve. Keep your hips straight back behind you. Reach for that hand or that leg, or that foot on the other side with that hand. Bring that hand that's reaching for the ceiling up toward the ceiling. Check to be sure your hips are still straight back behind you. And your hands going down toward the floor, and you're lifting up, looking up at that hand that's up. Just try that and see how it works for you. Breathe, feel it, think about it. When you come out of it, back in that Superman, inhale as you come up, exhale as your arms go down. Feel that. Deep breath. Okay, let's do some balancing positions. Let's do the toe twist. Inhale as you come up on your toes and your arms go out in front of you and just get a balance right there. And then when you're ready, twist around to the side, exhaling as you just go to one side, but leave your hips where they were. Your hip bones are straight out in front of you. Your arms and hands, and you're facing around to the side. Breathe, feel that. Hold it for as long as your body says okay, but don't hold your breath. When you get ready to come out of that, inhale as you come around, and exhale as you go down. Feel the blood flow into your fingers and feet, up toward your back, up your back and toward your head. Feel that. Breathe, relax, and let's go to the other side. Inhale as you come up, pull in your belly, tighten your hips. Exhale as you twist just at the waist. You've left those hips right where they were, and you're coming around to the side with your arms and your face. Breathe and feel this. And you can come out of it anytime you want to, or you can stay in it as long as you like. There's no competition in yoga, so you don't have to try to keep up with anybody. You just do what your body can do. When you're ready to come out, you're inhaling when you come around, exhaling when you go down, and relaxing. Deep breath, relax, feel that. Okay, let's do another balancing position. That means it's the arm and leg pull. It means we need to get our weight and balance on this right leg, and then inhale as you pick up your left leg and get some balance, and exhale, getting that balance, and then inhale as you raise that arm and breathe. Feel that weight in your leg. Feel that pull on that other leg, and the arm that you're using to pull your leg up, and the one you're using to reach the ceiling. When you're ready to come out, exhale as you bring that arm that was up down. Set that foot down, take a good deep breath, and feel your body, and notice the difference in the way your legs feel now. Breathe into both legs until they feel about the same. Relax. Let's get that balance on that left leg. Breathe as you're picking up your right leg. Exhale as you pull it back. Inhale as you reach for the ceiling. And breathe. Come out of that. Stay as long as you like, but if you want to come out, you're exhaling when your hand comes down, inhaling when you set that foot down. Get a good deep breath, relax, let's do the chest expansion for the legs apart. Good deep breath with your hands folded in front of you. Exhale. Inhale as you reach out in front of you and around beside you. Look up at the ceiling. Lean back. Clasp your hands together back behind you. And then straighten your back. Tuck in your chin. Bring your clasped hands up behind you. And roll down. Roll down from your shoulders, the middle of your back, the waist, at the hips, and then just hang there. Just relax from the hips, let yourself go, drop your head, relax your neck, let your arms relax, feel that stretch in the back of your legs, and just let your body hang here. Just breathe. Stay there as long as it feels good to you, not too long. You don't want to be dizzy when you come out. Pull your shoulders together behind you and roll up one vertebrae at a time. Inhaling all the way up. When you're up, relax your hands and exhale. Deep breath. Feel that. Let go. Now let's get back on our belly. Turn your head to the side. Put your hands down behind you. And just relax. Feel your body relax. Inhale as you raise your head. Let's do the cobra. Exhale as you put your forehead down. Inhale as you roll your head back. Grazing your nose and chin as they go by. Get your eyes in the tops of their sockets. Exhale as you bring your hands under your shoulders and inhale as you roll back. Just as far as your body says is okay. Try to keep your feet together. Keep your legs touching each other. Push back with your hands just until your body says that's it. And breathe. Hold that as long as it feels good to you. Notice how long you want to be here. Feel that stretch on your belly, that curve in your back. When you're ready to come out of that, you want to still be looking up and let yourself down one vertebra at a time, a little bit, just let your belly come down. Once you find that you can hold yourself up a little bit, put your hands back behind you, and then exhale as you bring your chest and chin and face down. Take a breath, turn your head to the side, and relax. See if you can feel your heartbeat. Now let's bring our hands around and get back in that tabletop, and we'll do the downward dog. Get your hands kind of under your shoulders, with your fingers apart, your knees are bent. Take a breath and bring your hips in the air and your heels down behind you with your head between your arms. And you can adjust your feet. You can bring your feet up a little closer to your hands. Try to have your feet right behind your hands, or you can have your feet back away from you a little bit more. Just find out what your body wants. But see if you can push your hips up toward the ceiling like you're trying to touch your tailbone to the ceiling. You want to straighten your back out. Try to have your ears between your arms so that your back of your neck is straight. Breathe and feel that. Now you stay as long as you like, or when you get ready to come out, just bend your knees, come back down, and get completely relaxed. Until you've got your hands back behind you, the tops of your feet on the floor, and relax. With your arms relaxed and your chin on the floor, let's do the half locust. Just pick up one leg, pull that leg in the air, and breathe. as long as it feels good. You know how long you want to be there. When you get ready to come out, exhale as you bring that toe down. Take a breath, turn your head back to the side and relax. Feel the effects of that position. And let's do the other way. Inhale as you put your chin down, exhale. Inhale as you raise that other leg. Relax these arms, let them just be there. They're not helping, they're just relaxing. Bring this leg up as high as you can. Breathe, don't hold your breath. And when you're ready to come out of that, you know your body will tell you you're ready to come out. You just exhale as your leg comes down. If you like it, you can stay there a while. When you're coming out, exhale. When your toe and leg touch, get a breath, turn your head to the side and relax. Let your body get over doing that half locus. Feel it, notice it, willing to relax. Find out if you're harboring any tension from doing it. Try to relax that. And then we're going to do the full locus. So roll to one side and get your arm under your body on that side. Roll to the other side and get that other arm under your body. And make a fist with your hands to push against the floor and raise both legs up. And that's the full locust. Your chin is down, your feet are up. Your fist are pushing against the floor to hold your feet in the air. You're breathing. Don't hold your breath. As long as you're breathing, and as long as you're paying attention to your body at the same time, you're doing yoga. Bring those legs down, relax, take a breath, pull your arms out, turn your head to the side, and let go. Let's see. Very slowly, get on the back. Move your body in such a way that lets your body know that you respect it, that you're paying attention to how you're moving it, and you're getting completely comfortable on your back. When you get there, we can do the fish if you like. With your knees bent, your back on the floor, you can lift. You can push your elbows against the floor and pull your head up until you've got this arch under your back. That just lets your all of your weight be on the back of your head and on your hips. And you can bring your arms out and put them up on your chest. Stay there as long as you like. When you're ready to come out, you can raise up. Or you can just let your back down and get completely relaxed, and we'll go into some deep relaxation. In order to get into deep relaxation, we start by using our minds to suggest to our bodies that our body relax. So tell your feet to relax. Wiggle your toes, turn your toes back toward you and down away from you. Roll your ankles a little bit, jiggle your kneecaps, pick your hips up again a little bit like we just did, and then drop them back down. Make a fist with your hands, stretch your fingers out, and then put the backs of your hands on the floor and feel your fingertips just kind of curling up toward your palms. Just relaxing your hands, relax your arms, relax your shoulders. Get a good deep breath and just feel your body relaxing. You're doing the sponge now. This is the sponge position. So let's just imagine now that we are sponges, and we've used our minds to relax our bodies, and now let's use our minds to relax our minds. Do something very relaxing, like imagining that you were a sponge on the bottom of the ocean. If you were a sponge and you lived in the ocean, you would just be attached, imagine maybe by the back of your head. Just feel like the only thing that's holding you on that ocean floor is the back of your head. But all of the rest of your body just feels like it's loose, could just float. Your arms are floating, your legs are floating, and you're breathing. A sponge would be breathing, wouldn't it? And imagine that you're just sucking in ocean water as you inhale. And within that ocean water is all of the nutrients that you need that are going into you and through you now. Just imagine being a sponge. With every breath, you're getting what you need from the ocean. And when you look around you, everybody else, everything else in the ocean is doing what it does. Fish are swimming by, some of them swimming right through you. All the big fish are swimming by. All the little fish are being chased. It's just the seaweed is flowing. You see it just gently going with the current, and you're doing the same thing. Just feel that in your mind. Imagine that you're a sponge. You can keep building that until you get so relaxed that you're in that center of peace that's within you. That peace is always with you. We just have to give our attention to it. And sometimes we can trick our minds by building these mental pictures that are peaceful. And then slip into that center of peace that's within you. This is where you're going now, into that peaceful state. Just thinking I'm breathing. That's all that's important, is this breath of air, just like a sponge in the ocean. Just relax. You can be here until you're ready to come out.